Hi everyone, in this video we're gonna learn how to download SQL Server and then how to set up this on our local Windows PC. For this we'll go to our browser and we'll type SQL Server download, and here you can see the first link is SQL Server downloads. Click this button. So this is the home page where Microsoft provides you the SQL Server installation for different versions. Right, the heading says try SQL Server on premises or in the cloud. So the very basic thing we need to understand that SQL Server is available on premises as well as on cloud. Either we choose to install the SQL Server on our local machine this way, or otherwise we can manage to run SQL Server from the cloud. Okay, so in this case what happens, all the SQL Server instances will be configured on Azure machine. Now what this Azure means, this is actually a cloud service managed by Microsoft, but you will see that it is a trial version. The SQL Server 2019 with the full capacity comes for a limited period, 180 days free trial, and after that you need to purchase it. This trial session will be expired after 180 days and then you need to purchase, otherwise it will not run. If you wish to purchase this one, you can click to this trial version. Otherwise SQL Server comes with free editions also. In this flavor you can see developer edition and express edition. Both the editions are perfectly fine for a beginner to start. The main basic difference is that it's a full-featured free edition license for user as a development and test database in a non-production environment. It means you cannot deploy it on a production environment in any organization. Otherwise, if you want to learn it, it is perfectly fine to download this edition. Okay. Now this different edition is Express Edition. It comes with some limitations. Some of features, like some administrative features, will not be available in this edition, but you can install it and you can run it without any restriction, either on your production environment, personally, professionally, on any of the server you can run this. As a learner or beginner, if you want to start, then we are perfectly fine to download either developer edition or express edition. Okay, so in this example we will start with developer edition. Click this download and you'll see download begins. Okay, it comes with a very tiny size of 5.7 something MB. Go to the folder where this file has been downloaded. We'll click to this one. Now you can see the SQL Server installation comes here in three types, either basic, custom or download media. In basic and custom, the SQL Server will connect you to the Microsoft website and will install the software and configure it on your local machine at the same time. Okay, so downloading and installation will happen simultaneously. In third way, that download media, SQL Server will download the complete installation file locally onto your machine, and then later you can use it to copy it into your pen drive and can use it on another machine as well. So in this example I will go with this download media. Now here you can see again we are getting two options. Either we can install it as a image file or as a self-executable exe file. Okay, so I would better go with the ISO file because it is of smaller size, and then go to download. Once the download is completed, I will go to C drive where I have my SQL Server ISO file, and yes, this is here. So we first need to mount this drive. Once you'll select this one, you can see a disk image tool available here, and from here you can mount it. Now once it is mounted, you can see the setup icon here. Simply double click this. yes, and you will see installation started. It is configuring at the initial stage. Let me minimize this window. This is SQL Server Installation Center. We'll go to installation and we'll select this new SQL Server standalone installation. This new pop-up window appears. It says it is a free edition, developer. We have other options, evolution and express, but both are limited one. Evolution again comes with 180 days of limited period, so we'll go with developer only. Otherwise, if we have the license key, we can provide the product key here and go with the licensed version. But we'll choose developer and next. Accept terms and condition, next. If you want to keep this installed version up to date, you can choose this checkbox. Otherwise, in my case, I will uncheck this and go to next. It is checking for prerequisites. Now in installation rules, we have some warning for firewall. That is perfectly fine at this stage. Go to next. So at this stage, we'll go with the SQL Server database engine only. There are other services also provided, which you can see, analysis services, machine learning services, but we'll make this installation simple. So in this installation, we'll choose only the basic components, which is actually required for database installation. We'll not make this installation very complicated. So choose client tool connectivity, SQL client connectivity SDK, and very important, that database engine services. I have already installed one SQL Server instance, so I cannot provide any new default instance again here, because on every machine we can have n number of installations of SQL Server, but only one default instance is allowed. So this time we need to provide some name of this instance. Let's say MSSQL 19. Next, click next. Now this is the confirmation screen, where SQL Server telling us that what services it is going to install on this machine. We are fine with this. Go to install, and now here actual installation begins. Now installation completed here. Close this window. Now check this installation. We can see SQL Server 2019 has been installed on this machine. This is the configuration manager. But there is no management studio installed, using which we can connect to the server. So we need to install SQL Server Management Studio, which is a developer tool to connect to the database server and firing queries. Go to the browser again and search for SQL Server Management Studio for SQL Server 2019. Here we can see the first link, download SQL Server Management Studio, and this is the download link. So SQL Server Management Studio has been downloaded. Go to the folder, and from here we can install this. Double click. Click yes. Click install. So Management Studio installation has been completed here, and it is asking for restart the system. I will restart my machine. Okay, now the system has been restarted. We'll go to SQL Server Management Studio. This is the SQL Server recent tool which we have just installed. Go to the Management Studio. Okay, so SQL Server has started. Now you can see this is the instance which we have just installed, and this is my machine name. Fine, and now we can connect to the server. Now, so the database has been connected. Thank you everybody for watching this video. Please like this video and subscribe my channel so I can get motivated and keep posting more such learning videos. Thank you.